Dr. Gregory. How are you doing?
I'm fine, Glenda. How are you?
Okay. One of the things that I'm very interested in and with people is understanding their creative process. Have you ever thought about your creative process and thought in what ways you are creative?
I go through a process. I have to be extremely, I have to get, you know, be in a space where I'm, you know, my head is clear. You know, I have to, I know that there's a time of day that works better for me, and that if it isn't within that certain, you know, sort of window, that I won't get the best of me. So I've thought about that over those kinds of things over the years. And I also know that it just comes. You know, it's not something I can force. If I'm forcing, then, I mean, I suppose, you know, anything that comes out of you is created and so creative, but the best of me comes out if I'm not forcing. If I'm forcing, then I don't get the best of me. So I've thought about that, those kinds of things.
So what time do you find that you're most creative?
Between 9 in the morning and 3 p.m. If you get me before 9 in the morning, forget it. If you get me after 3, I'm tired. I just can't do it anymore. So
what do you do to put yourself in that space in which you're not forcing and you're just kind of flowing?
Well, I just became used to just letting it go. And my creative work tends to be writing and writing academically. You know, I write articles and, you know, been working on a book, but that's what I do. That's what I love. That is, and also teaching. So that's always been, you know, I'm very good at delivering content. So because of how I do it, it's very creative how I do it. And I'm always reinventing, you know, how I do it. So whereas a lot of faculty members may just come in and do the same thing all the time, I'm very creative. I probably don't do a class the same way every time, you know, because I, you know, something new comes out of me and something I continue to grow and learn and develop. So therefore, what I do tends to do that. And how I put myself in there is I just sort of, in the zone to do that, I just sort of do it. But I can tell you that I have been a meditator since I was 20 years old. And I've done yoga since I was 20 years old. So I have done deep breathing since then, you know, since I was 20 years old. So those kinds of things, because I do that, have gotten me in touch with deeper levels. And so it's really easy for me to go into a deeper level where I'm more is available to me in terms of the creative process.
So, okay, so could you define?
For instance, you know, in terms of brain waves, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. So, you know, alpha is where you operate on a daily level, you know, just your everyday activities. The deeper you go in, then the more creative. And I think it's theta that is like the most creative of the brain waves. And so I've been doing meditation for, you know, decades, so I know how to get into those kinds of spaces pretty quickly. And so that, I mean, just sitting down at my computer to write something that I want to be writing puts me in the zone. I can go almost in the meditative state just by sitting down, knowing that when I'm sitting down, I got to do some, you know, administrative stuff I do every day. That's just, that doesn't put me in the zone. But when I know that it's something that I care about that I want to be working on, I can just do it. You know, Dr. Fonte and I have been working on a book, and we've been, and I'll have a deadline or something that I committed to him that I would do such and such a thing, and I will put it off, and then I know, well, I got to do it because I told him I'd do it by this time, and then I'll just is when I go with intent to go and do it, I go, yes, okay, today is going to be that day. I promised it. I'm going to do it. And I go sit down to do it. And I'm thinking before that, but I don't know what I'm going to, what am I going to say? I have no clue. And I think, this is going to be terrible. I'm going to send this to him. He's going to think I'm crazy. And I sit down. I go with intent. I sit down. And it comes. And he'll invariably email me back and say, that's great. This is wonderful. You know, this is exactly what you know. And I'm like, and I don't know where that came from. You know, so. But that's what happens to me.
Do you read a lot on the subject, or have you in the past, and now you just...
I've read a lot in the past. I do read things that I get me updated, you know, in terms of whatever project I'm working on. Mm-hmm. And so I'll read something new. Oh, ooh, that's exciting about this. But I've read a lot, you know, over the years. And
So who do you read on the metaphysical, spiritual, meditative? You know.
Well, I've read every line Ken Wilber's written, pretty much. So, mm-hmm. you know, you got to keep it. So I usually know when people are misquoting or misrepresenting what Ken has to say. So mm-hmm. I've read that. And, you know, that's not easy reading at all. That's really difficult reading. But so that occupied a lot of my more recent years,
mm-hmm.
His work and, you know, a lot of the work on complexity and, you know, complexity theory and, you know, that kind of thing is what I've been really interested in.
Mm-hmm.
And so recently, it's more that if I have a specific project, then I'm reading the work related to the project. For instance, our one project that we were working on was looking at the leadership of Nelson Mandela and Malcolm X via their autobiographies,
mm-hmm.
but in looking at it from an integral perspective. And so in order to do that, of course, we had to read both biographies, autobiographies, which are long. And then, in addition to that, I read literature. I read things that came from others that were related to their autobiographies. Things that I read a dissertation from a family member of Malcolm X. So that's the kind of reading I've been doing lately, because that's the project we've been working on,
mm-hmm.
in addition, you know, as a part of the book that we've been doing. So
so
I've been, you know, really getting into a lot of that.